And so, on the 13th of November in the year 1002, 1016 years ago, the St. Brice's Day Massacre took place throughout the whole of England, and Coventry was involved in the St. Brice's Day Massacre. For what had happened was, the king, Ethelred the Unready, had been warned that the Danes were overtaking, and there were Danes in Coventry. The Danes in Coventry were at places like Biggin Hall, the Biggin Hall Hotel up in Stoke. They were also at places like Orsley and Kersley, their Danish names. And what happened was the king passed word through the land to kill every Danish mother, father and child. And unfortunately, this had severe backlashes on the king because of what he did. He was in a situation where, unfortunately, the Danish king's sister got murdered. And so over the next 14 years, they caused complete and utter devastation by coming through the whole of England. And unfortunately, they came through Coventry, where they sacked the house at Coombe Abbey and they sacked the house at Stoneleigh Abbey. And as they came through Coventry here in 1016, they murdered all the nuns down here at Coventry Priory. Well, it wasn't Coventry Priory then, it was St. Osberg's Nunnery. And they murdered all the nuns on the spot, and the nuns literally fell into the ground and their blood soaked into the ground. And that was the St. Brice's Day Massacre. It then went on to be celebrated throughout England later on in terms of the Hock Tuesday play and Hock Tuesday. And Queen Elizabeth I herself witnessed it as a Hock Tuesday play and was said to laugh about what had happened. But that was actually on this site here in Coventry, where Edric Streona and the Danish, especially led by King Canute himself, who died on the 12th of November, King Canute and Edric Streona killed all the nuns and they literally burnt the house down in this area.